According to a report by the World Health Organization's International Agency for Cancer Research, in Uganda, 34,008 new cases and 22,992 deaths caused by cancer occurred in 2020, and 62,548 people were living with cancer by 2020.
Talking about the burden of cancer in this country, many times we all, even as health workers, we forget about children. Yeah. One, people out of our communities and our homes and in the public should know cancer is a disease that actually affects children. Not affecting them by their mothers and fathers suffering from it, but children do suffer from cancer as well. And here at the Uganda Cancer Institute, every year we receive at least 500 children who are coming for the first time with cancer. In 2020, we had 6,959 people newly diagnosed with cancer of the cervix. And it's important for people to appreciate that when we say cervical cancer is the commonest, it's indeed the commonest, and it's the greatest burden, you know, cancer burden that we have as a country.
Cancer continues to kill more people than malaria and HIV/AIDS globally. So Rotarians couldn't sit back and watch. We had to take action. We've been serving by working with partners. One of the key partners we work with is the Uganda Cancer Society, because we found very staggering statistics.
While many have watered it down to just a myth and a taboo, cancer is real and has lived amongst us for many years. It is alarming how many people battle the agony of the disease every waking day.
My name is Caro Akelo, and I'm a cancer patient.
My name is Samuel Chieza Mukasa, a prostate cancer survivor.
At the time when I got to know that I had cancer, I really didn't know or have a lot of information about the disease. It was like one of those diseases that you just hear about that exists and you don't expect that it can ever happen to you.
It was in July 2021. That's when I got in contact with the Uganda Cancer Society. And that period made me active with the society. And I was involved in their programs, especially cancer awareness, mainly of the prostate. I didn't know much about cancer before I was diagnosed, because I thought I was young. And secondly, as I told you, I knew by the virtue of my understanding that cancer or prostate was for those men who went about with so many women and they had STIs. I thought cancer, prostate cancer, was an STI. So I didn't even bother myself, because I had only one wife, and I have not zigzagged anyhow in my life. I have been in church most of my life.
People just like you and I are diagnosed with cancer every day, but oftentimes wonder, what next after the diagnosis? Who do I run to for help?
The help I have received, I have got it from UCCF. That is where I started from, which is a member of UCS. And then WHOCASO, and then CAO. They're the main organizations that have been there, that have really given me a lot of support.
We use our teleclubs to reach the people, cancer patients. We use the clubs to create awareness. We carry out free screening services all across the country. Again, there we are working with partners. But equally important is for the cancer patients, we work with partners. And I remember a case in point was when, during COVID, when cancer patients were so badly hit. We have partners who are already there in the field. The cancer site, actually.
WHOCASO supports patients various ways and with the other members of Uganda Cancer Society. Our councils will do the counseling. We have a number of survivors who use their own experiences to counsel patients and they navigate them through the complex systems using their own experience because they've been there before. But these patients have other needs and other psychosocial and social needs. So we work with other members of the society, other members provide accommodation, others provide the transportation, others provide food. And we do this mobilization together as members of the Uganda Cancer Society and the Society on the Head.
The Cancer Society, the Uganda Cancer Society is set up to play a role of a coordinator or coordination of a number of civil society organizations that deal with offering services to cancer patients. And these services range from palliative care, management of patients, managing patient hostels, managing cancer survivor patients. And so to date, the Uganda Cancer Society boasts of having over 40 civil society organizations under its umbrella.
At the Uganda Cancer Society, we are passionate about our fight against cancer, and we believe that the possibilities are endless in putting an end to the illness. Join us and let us fight cancer together.
So what I really appreciate about UCS and its members is, first of all, they were there with me from the beginning of my journey. Right from the day that I got my diagnosis, I had someone to talk to me.
The Uganda Cancer Society is currently really committed to ensure that cancer care and treatment is given a priority. So through our partners, the American Cancer Society, the Uganda Cancer Institute, we are really committed to ensure that we fulfill the vision of the society, which is to have a cancer-free population in Uganda.